What's up guys, this is Usama and it's time to do a speed test comparison between the Galaxy A30 and the Galaxy A50. These are the new mid-ranges by the South Korean giant and it is Samsung's take on companies like Huawei and Xiaomi. Right in front of me, I have the Galaxy A30 and the Galaxy A50. The one in white color is the Galaxy A30, the one in blue color is the Galaxy A50. These phones are powered by the Exynos SoCs. For example, the Galaxy A30 has a Exynos 7904 chipset with a RAM of 4GB, and the Galaxy A50 has the Exynos 9610 SoC with a RAM of 4GB. So guys, right now I have both these devices turned off. To begin with the speed test, I will first boot up these devices and let's see which one boots up faster. Here we go. So the Galaxy A50 is a clear winner here. The Galaxy A30 is taking its time to boot up. Now that both phones are up, I would like to test out the face unlock speed on these devices. Both phones offer the face ID, so let's go ahead and try that. So guys, as far as the face ID is concerned, sometimes the Galaxy A30 unlocks the phone faster, sometimes the Galaxy A50 unlocks the phone before the Galaxy A30 does. So I would not call one of these devices a winner over the other. I would rather call it a tie between these devices. These have the similar unlocking speeds. So the next unlock option that we have on both the phones is the fingerprint reader. Unfortunately, we do not have a screen fingerprint reader on the Galaxy A30. We have an optical reader at the back of this phone. So it would be really unfair if we try to compare the fingerprint scanners on both these devices. We can just tap this one here, and on the Galaxy A50, we can tap the fingerprint scanner here on the display to unlock the phone. The Galaxy A50's fingerprint scanner is really slow because it's not pretty much optimized. However, the Galaxy A30 unlocks a phone at a lightning fast speed. So without any further ado, let's get on to the application speed test of the Galaxy A50 and the Galaxy A30 now. First of all, we have the Facebook application here on both these devices. Before I launch the Facebook application, I would like to show you that I have absolutely nothing open on these devices beforehand. So let's go ahead and launch the Facebook application now. The Galaxy A30 is a winner here. Before I launch Messenger, I would like to tell you guys that both phones are connected to the same internet connection. There is no difference between the internet speed here. Let's launch the Facebook Messenger now. Galaxy A50 does a better job this time. It's time to launch Instagram. Both phones have equal loading speed for the feed of Instagram. Let's launch Twitter. The Galaxy A50 wins once again. Let's launch WhatsApp. Galaxy A50 once again. Let's launch Reddit. Galaxy A50 is slightly ahead once again, but the Galaxy A30 loaded the feed earlier. Let's launch the Google Chrome. Galaxy A50 is ahead once again. Let's try opening a website on Google Chrome on both the phones. Wikipedia. Galaxy A30 loaded the website faster. The Gmail application. Galaxy A50. Google Maps. Galaxy A50 once again. The VLC media player. Galaxy A50 once again. Spotify. Galaxy A50 is a clear winner. YouTube. Galaxy A50 once again. Adobe Acrobat. Galaxy A50. Microsoft Word. Galaxy A50 and A30 both have the same speed. Evernote. Galaxy A50. The Cam Scanner application. Galaxy A50 is ahead. Now we have the Snapchat application on both devices. Galaxy A50. SoundCloud. Galaxy A50 once again. We have the Google Play Store here. Galaxy A50. We have the Snapseed application here. Galaxy A50 loaded, Snapseed better. So guys, the next thing that I would like to do here is I would like to edit a picture on both the phones, and then I will export the picture to find out the processing speed on both the phones. So I will just choose a random picture from my gallery, in fact the same picture on both the phones. Let's go ahead and let's try an effect on these pictures. Okay, the effect has been applied. I will just press save on both the phones at the same time. The phone that exports the picture earlier will be the winner here. Galaxy A30 saved the picture earlier. I don't know how come this Exynos 7904 has beaten the Exynos 9610 here. So next up we have the Viber video editor here. And now I will just edit a video quickly on both these devices to see which device processes the video faster. Let's try cutting this video clip into half. This would be good enough. Here we go. So the Galaxy A50 is way ahead. It did a pretty good job here. Next up, we have the Netflix application in both the phones. Loads up on Galaxy A50 faster once again. So I would like to launch some stock applications on both the devices. I forgot to launch the stock applications earlier, so I'm going to do it now. Let's go ahead with the phone application first of all. Galaxy A50 wins. Now we have the messages application. Galaxy A50 once again. The stock internet browser. Galaxy A50 once again. And lastly, we have the camera application. Galaxy A50 once again. So guys, now I would like to launch some games. I have some small games and some heavier games as well. In the small games, I have Subway Surfers first of all. Let's launch Subway Surfers to see which phone wins here. The Galaxy A50 is loading Subway Surfer. Galaxy A50 wins this competition too. The Galaxy A30 is taking its time to load the game. I don't know where this phone was stuck. Okay, so next we have the Temple Run 2 here. Let's see which one wins for Temple Run 2. Galaxy A50 is way ahead this time as well. Okay, so the Galaxy A50 wins when it comes to launching Temple Run 2 as well. Next up, I have the FIFA mobile game. Let's try launching this game. So the Galaxy A50 seems to be ahead once again. Let's launch the 8-ball pool now. Galaxy A50 is the winner once again. And lastly, I have a heavy game that I will load on both the devices. And this is the PUBG Mobile that I will run now. Let's see. Galaxy A50 seems to be winning once again. It's already on the checking update menu and it's ahead of the Galaxy A30. It's clear that the Exynos 9610 is a really powerful processor for this kind of a mid-ranger, and it's clearly beating the 7904 processor of the Galaxy A30. So it's time to check the RAM management on both these devices. As I mentioned earlier, these phones are equipped with a RAM of 4GB each. So let's go ahead and see which applications are still sticking inside the memory of the Galaxy A30 and the Galaxy A50. It looks like all the applications are still there. So let's try launching these applications one by one once again to see which applications load from the previous point. Both phones are loading Facebook from scratch. Next up, we can load the Temple Run 2. Okay, both phones are loading Temple Run 2. Next up, we can load the Subway Surfers. Okay, Subway Surfers is still there on both the phones. After this, we can load Snapseed. It's still there on both the devices. SoundCloud. It's loading from scratch on both the devices. Evernote. Office. It's also loading from scratch on these devices. PUBG Mobile. PUBG Mobile is still there on the Galaxy A50 and it's loading once again on the Galaxy A30. To conclude this video, I would like to tell you that the Galaxy A30 doesn't have as good RAM management as the Galaxy A50. However, it's also evident that the Galaxy A50's 9610 SoC is way superior than the Exynos 7904. Towards the end of this video, you will be able to watch the 2-3D benchmark speed test between the Galaxy A30 and the Galaxy A50. So watch the speed test with patience and don't forget to drop your feedback in the comment section down below. Hit like if you find this video useful. Do consider subscribing to my channel if you are new here. I will see you in another one really soon. See ya.